According to the Probst-Machart epithelial ingrowth classification, in grade 1, there is a thin ingrowth, 1 to 2 cells thick, limited to within 2 mm of the flap edge, transparent, difficult to detect, with a well-delineated white line along the advancing edge with no associated flap changes, and it is non-progressive. The presence of a demarcation line indicates that it is very unlikely to progress further, and simple observation is adequate. In grade 2, there is thicker ingrowth. Discrete cells are evident within the nest, at least 2 mm from the flap edge. Individual cells are translucent, easily seen on the slit lamp. No demarcation line is present. The corneal flap edge may be rolled or gray. There is no flap edge melting or erosion usually. Fluorescent staining indicates an active communication with the surface epithelium and likelihood that the ingrowth will progress. Treatment is usually required within 2 to 3 weeks. In grade 3, there is pronounced ingrowth, which is several cells thick, greater than 2 mm from the flap edge. Ingrowth areas are opaque, obvious on the slit lamp. White geographic areas of necrotic epithelial cells with no demarcation line. Corneal flap margins are rolled with thickened whitish-gray appearance. Progression results in large areas of flap melting from collagenase release from the necrotic epithelium. Confluent haze develops peripheral to the flap edge as flap pulls away, leaving exposed stromal bed in contact with the surface epithelium. Urgent treatment is required with close follow-up as recurrences are more common due to the altered flap edges. Irregular corneal astigmatism and involvement of the visual axis are the main causes of diminished vision in epithelial ingrowth. The most common treatment involves lifting of the flap, scraping the epithelial cells off of its underside and the stromal bed, and repositioning the flap. Others fix the flap so that it remains stable. Some apply absolute alcohol to the underside of the flap. Phototherapeutic keratectomy may be combined with manual scraping. ND-YAG laser may be used in early cases to avoid lifting the flap. And amniotic membrane can be used as a biological pressure patch. If you like this video, you may show your appreciation by making a small contribution to help support the channel. Here below the video window, click on Super Thanks. Choose the amount you would like to contribute and then click Buy and Send to complete the transaction. Thank you.